Why didn't Dmitry Pozharsky become tsar after the time of troubles? He had all the chances. The Pozharsky family goes back to the Rurikovich family. One of the ancestors of Prince Dmitry, Andrei Starodubsky, was a commander at the Kulikovo field. In May 1611, Pozharsky fought with the Poles in the street of Moscow and was seriously wounded. Later on, he became the leader of the Nizhny Novgorod militia while still recovering from the wounds. In November 1612, the militia stormed Kitai-Gorod district of Moscow. The city was liberated from the invaders. The following year, Pozharsky was nominated for the tsardom at the Zemsky Sobor, the highest representative assembly of Russia. But he declined this proposition in favor of the 16-year-old Mikhail Romanov. The crowning of a young man who had not been involved in the troubles reconciled the rival groups. Pozharsky wasn't the first leader who tried to stop a civil catastrophe, but he was the first one to give up his personal ambitions, and that made him victorious.